Hello, everybody. So glad that you could join us for our special day today. We're going to have a little pre-wedding video here and share some special moments. We'd just like to say thank you for joining us. Each one of you have been important in some way in our lives.
Absolutely.
And we really appreciate you taking time to be with us today. Thank you.
Yeah. And one of the things that we're going to do in our little video today is we've got some family from both Ann's side and my side. And we realize that there are many of you that don't know Ann or you don't know me. But we know each other. And we hope that after today you'll have a little better sense of who we are and our families some family connections, and we got something special to share from our grandkids. You want to tell us about that, Ann?
Sure. So we asked our grandchildren what we should look for in a mate.
Ooh, that's a loaded question.
And they came up with some wonderful advice that we would like to share with you.
Yeah. It's pretty cool. I think it's almost worth watching this video for. So, we're going to have just a few moments of some special moments that Ann and I have shared over the last few months. And it's a real privilege to be able to share them with you. And we are so thankful to have all of you join with us today. And we hope that we can get to see some of you in the days ahead. And anyway, enjoy our day. Thank you for being with us.
Ann and Dave, we celebrate this new love that you share together. You can truly say with the psalmist,
"You have turned my mourning into dancing. You've removed my sackcloth and clothed me with joy, that my heart may sing your praises and not be silent. O Lord my God, I will praise you forever."
You both have proven true and faithful over so many years, and now God is putting you together in this new marriage. And your former spouses, Barb and Pat, also, as they entered their last days, both encouraged you to remarry.
And your marriage is an invitation to all of us watching to walk through suffering, but in God's presence, with open hands and a soft heart, so that healing and comfort can come. It was only in that fertile soil that this new springtime was made possible, this blossoming of a new marriage.
And a COVID romance is not easy. During the restrictions, you've found it difficult to spend the amount of time with family that you would have wanted to, but you made it work.
We were able to spend 2 afternoons with you in Comox across the fence at social distance gathering, but it was amazing to see you for the first time together and see your passion for investing in people, to see your priority of honoring God in your conversation, and to see that Dave also loves to give thanks to God in all circumstances.
And it was fun on that Easter day watching the Easter egg hunt, socially distanced Easter egg hunt over the fence, but with Ann's grandchildren. And the care and the love that you showed, we can see that there's plenty of fun ahead for the grandchildren and your combined family.
And your gifts dovetailed beautifully. Dave was even able to convince Anne to take a nap on Sunday. Now that's a powerful gift.
Yes, so we share your high hopes for many years of happy marriage together. And in whatever adventures you set out upon, congratulations to you.
Alrighty, we got some good stuff here to talk about. Tell us what we're going to do.
So, between the two of us, we have lots of grandchildren, and we decided that we were going to ask our grandchildren for advice. If I was looking for a new husband, what should I look for? What kind of guy would he be? And you asked,
if I was looking for a new wife, what kind of a woman would she be? What kind of person would she be?
And they've come up with some great advice.
Amazing advice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Almost all of them said, well, the person has to love God.
Yeah.
With his whole heart.
And with her heart.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And they said, he has to love you. And he has to love kids, and he has to love us. All of them are open to relationship. So another one of the things was, you have to have fun.
I like fun.
you have to watch their sports.
I like that.
And you have to be able to sleep on the couch.
Really? Mm-hmm. Wow. I guess it'll be cozy. That's good. My grandkids, a lot of the same things. Great values of our kids, loving God, mm-hmm. loving them. And my kids said they really want a woman who would really love Papa. So, and I know you do.
Yeah.
I love what some of the kids talked about was just the person that I would marry would have a kind heart, would be someone who would be generous, and someone who was like a good Samaritan, willing to help people in need. And I thought that was a great one because I see that in you, man. Someone who likes to read stories and willing to be with them in good times and hard times. Someone who likes to cook.
I like to cook.
And have bring snacks, make sure we don't run out of popcorn, and every once in a while a little candy's good. Mm. You know, these kids have really important values, so it's good. But here's the last one I want to say. One of the kids said, Papa, you need to follow Nana's advice. And Nana said, don't spend the rest of your life alone, because it won't do you any good to be alone. So
I think you've been told by a 9-year-old.
I've been told to follow Nana's advice. So
beautiful.
Yeah. Great advice from our kids. And we just want to say to all our grandkids, we love you guys. Mm-hmm. And you are really important to Ann and I.
Hello to all of you that are celebrating with Dave and Anne today. I'm Dave's sister, Charlene, and this is my husband, John.
Hey!
Congratulations, Dave and Anne, on this, your wedding day. We really wish that we could be with you. And when we were visiting Dave last fall, we were a little bit suspicious that there might be something going on. He would disappear and say that he was on a Zoom call, or we thought he was at work. But really, I think he was talking to his sweetie. Then when we were back home, he let us know about you, and he let us know that you lived in Victoria and that there was going to be some trips made there. And then began the COVID restrictive dates. We knew that he had somebody very special. Dave, we're thrilled that God has brought Anne into your life. And on behalf of our family, we welcome your new bride.
Right on.
In Psalms 32:8, it says like this: I will guide you along the best pathway for your life. I will advise you and watch over you. We bless you both today.
Yay!
Have a wonderful day.
Well, and we've had some really special moments over the last number of months. Mm-hmm. And even right now, this is pretty cool. This is kind of in your backyard. Mm-hmm. And it's great that we have this beautiful venue to be able to share a little bit of our story. And, you know, Anne, one of the things that I just remember with deep fondness, and I'll never forget it, was the first time that I actually shared the words to you, "I love you." And I remember it took a while for me to get to that point, just because I didn't want them to be empty words. And I wanted to know in my heart it's from God. But in that moment, I knew you were kind of in the same, thinking the same way. But I'll never forget when you actually said back to me in that moment, "Dave, I receive your love." And that was very, very special. And I want to just say, before we share a little bit from our journals, our reflections, that I love you and I honor you. I honor your family and I honor your story. I honor your love story with Pat, and just the blessing of his life to you and to your family. And I just want to thank you. I want to thank you for being the woman of God. A woman of God, a tremendous person, and loves Jesus, loves her family, and loves me too. So, I'm so thankful for you, Anne. Thank you. You want to share some of your journal?
So early on in our relationship, I came home and wrote, "My heart is singing unbelievable special moments, ours. Deeply connecting gentleness. I feel so at home in Dave's presence, such an accepting, non-judgmental space, such an encouraging, awe-inspiring invitation to open to each other, to love and be loved, to know and be known. The tender time at the falls, the time sitting by the fire, the walks in town, the waterway, watching the moon rise, biking the galloping goose."
Good moments.
Yeah. "Cooking together, sharing histories of God's provision, plans, losses, joys, and love. Those subtle moments when the realization dawns on me that I am falling in love. Those deep touching moments when I realize I'm witnessing a miracle of being able to love again. That I'm letting some of those walls and barriers down that I felt I had to erect to keep my focus on my family and my ministry. And now I realize it seems like these focuses are enriched in companioning and supporting one another to love God, to love family, and to love others." You know, Dave, I've been thinking about some of the things that I love about you. I like that you're emotionally healthy, you're attentive and sensitive, responsive, and I'm drawn to your tender heart. I like that your very practical, operational theology invites God into every part of your life. I see that your walk and your talk are congruent. I love your creativity and spontaneity, that you're always ready for adventure and fun. I love that you have a servant's heart and a great work ethic. You proved your love when you helped me insulate under the cabin.
That's quite the adventure.
You have a willingness to honor, care for, and create community, and I really appreciate that. I like that you're so thoughtful and you plan for meaningful romantic times. I'm so grateful for the love that you and Barb shared. She was my friend, and the fruit of your love was evident in her life. And you have wonderful children that have come from that love. I'm so grateful that we've both been open to and had the courage to love again. I love you so deeply.
Yeah, thank you, Ed. Beautiful words.
Mm-hmm. And you have some things in your journal.
Yeah. Another special moment that I think back to is it was the morning after I asked you to marry me. And so this is what I wrote. Last night, I asked Anne to marry me. And to my great delight, she said, yes. And as I reflected on that moment, I realized that the truth is that we are both saying yes. We are both saying yes, not only to each other, but we are saying yes to God. We're saying yes to His plan and His purposes for our lives. And it was just a very meaningful time. And I remember asking Anne about just some special words that maybe she had that would help us kind of describe this journey we had been on. And the words that we both kind of came up with were the words surprised, but not surprised. And the reality is, we have been wowed and awed by the amazing love that is exploding in our hearts. And even though we have both experienced great love and great loss in our past, there is a sense that God is tailoring something very special and unique for us today, something from heaven that I am truly grateful to God for as we begin this new season of our lives. And so, yes, we are surprised at how we feel, but in reality, we are not surprised by God's goodness, by His kindness, and His generosity in our lives, and that our loving God, our Heavenly Father, is doing what He promised for both of us. He is making all things beautiful. And in this time, He has brought our lives together. And Anne, I just want to say, I am so grateful to God for you. And I look forward to spending the rest of my life with you. Thank you, Anne. I love you.
As we gather in this beautiful place to worship today, I'm reminded of the verse from Psalms. The heavens declare the glory of God. The skies proclaim the works of his hands. As we sit in this beautiful place, let us worship God who created all this beauty. We're gathered here in the sight of God and these witnesses to join together Anne Kathleen McCaffrey and David Martin Postal in marriage. Receive your bride. Welcome family and friends and loved ones, in person and online. We gather today to celebrate the wedding of Dave and Anne. You are sharing this commitment they make to one another, to offer your love and support to their union, and to allow Anne and Dave to start their married life together in communion with the people dearest and most important to them. We want to thank you for your part in their lives, and they ask for your blessing, encouragement, and lifelong support for their decision to be married. Today, it is a great honor and joy for Anne to be accompanied by her sons, Christopher and David. And Dave is surrounded by his sons, Jeremy, Matt, and Jabin. John is unable to be here today because of COVID travel restrictions. However, he is standing with his dad in spirit and with us online. Dave and Anne are thankful for the love and the blessing of their families as they come together in marriage. Their sons and their families are standing with them and blessing them. And just as Jesus blessed the wedding in Canaan by his promise, today we are inviting his presence and blessing to be upon us. So let us pray. Father God, we thank you for your grace, your mercy, and your everlasting love. Thank you that you are here. Thank you, you are present to bless this union of this couple together. Father, we thank you that you love them and care about them in such a deep way, that you've brought them together as a gift to one another. Bless this time in Jesus' name, amen. So I'm honored to be performing this ceremony and have a bit of a vested interest. Anne is my wonderful sister-in-law, who Chris and I have shared many projects and adventures with. And then Dave is a longtime fishing buddy. It wasn't too long ago that Dave started a new kind of fishing in my boat. He started asking questions about this lady standing in front of him. And you know, as the rest they say is going to be history. Dave and Anne, you both have already had wonderful love stories. And now God is joining you together in a love that is unique, experiencing the miracle of loving deeply again. God has given us a model of love at its finest in 1 Corinthians 13. I had an old pastor friend years ago tell me when he read this, always substitute your name for the word love. So listen to it with that in mind. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy, does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. Love always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. Thank you, guys. Ann and Dave, marriage is the promise between two people who love each other, who trust that love, who honor one another as individuals in that togetherness, and who wish to spend the rest of their lives together. It enables the two separate souls to share their desires, longings, dreams, and memories, their joys and sorrows, and to help each other through all the uncertainties of life. The oneness of a strong marriage is a safe haven for each of you to become your best self, while together you become better than you ever could be alone. You are adding to your life not only the affection of each other, but also the companionship and blessing of a deep trust. You are agreeing to share strength, responsibilities, and love. Your relationship will take the commitment of love. It will take trust to know in your hearts that you want only the best for each other. It will take dedication to stay open to each other, to learn and grow, even when it is difficult to do so. And finally, your relationship will take faith to go forward together without knowing what the future holds for you both. Dave and Ann, these people attending online and in person are your family, your chosen family. When you go through difficulties, lean on each other. Lean on your families. Lean on your friends. And lean on the Father. Ann and Dave, please join hands for your vows. Will you, Dave, take Anne to be your wife?
I will.
Will you, Anne, take Dave to be your husband?
I will.
Repeat after me. I, Dave, take you, Anne.
I, Dave, take you, Anne.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to love and respect you.
I promise to love and respect you.
To honor you and be faithful to you.
To honor you and be faithful to you.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
This is my sacred promise.
This is my sacred promise.
And covenant before God and these witnesses.
And covenant before God and these witnesses.
I, Ann, take you, Dave.
I, Ann, take you, Dave.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to love and respect you.
I promise to love and respect you.
To honor you and be faithful to you.
to honor you and be faithful to you.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In sorrow and in joy.
In sorrow and in joy.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
This is my sacred promise.
This is my sacred promise.
And covenant before God and these witnesses.
And covenant before God and these witnesses.
Anne and Dave, you'll exchange these rings with each other as an outward expression of your love and promise for each other. Made of precious metal, they are symbolic of how precious you are to each other. The ring is a never-ending circle that speaks of the unfailing love of God and your continuing love for each other. You will wear these rings as a continual reminder of your love and commitment to each other. Anne, I give you this ring.
Anne, I give you this ring.
As my promise to you.
As my promise to you.
That I will keep this sacred covenant.
That I will keep this sacred covenant.
And perform these vows.
And perform these vows.
And do you receive this ring as an expression of Dave's promise to you?
I do.
Dave, I give you this ring.
Dave, I give you this ring.
As my promise to you.
As my promise to you.
That I will keep this sacred covenant.
That I will keep this sacred covenant.
And perform these vows.
And perform these vows.
Dave, do you receive this ring as an expression of Anne's promise to you?
I do.
Dave and Anne, before God and these witnesses, you have declared your love and faithfulness to one another and have given and received rings as an expression of your sacred covenant. By the power invested in me, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I pronounce you husband and wife. And what God has joined together, let no one separate. You may kiss the bride. Communion celebrates coming together, coming into union. As Dave and Anne partake in communion today, they are reflecting on and remembering their union and love story with Christ, which is the foundation of their union and love story with each other and with their families. Let us pray. Jesus, we thank you for Dave and for Anne. We thank you for their commitment to you and also to their families. We thank you, Father, that your blessing is upon them. That you, Lord God, will open the windows of heaven over them. And God, regardless of what's going on in the world around, your blessing will be upon them. You will grant them favor in whatever they do, whatever they put their hands to. Father, may they be a blessing to those around them. May they grow together. And Lord, as they grow together, may they see your provision of love and goodness be expressed as those who come in contact with them will know your peace, God, and your love. Father, may their children and their children's children be blessed. May the light of your presence shine upon them, Lord, and give them grace and mercy in whatever they're going through, whatever they go through. Father, may your protection be upon them. Father, we pray for their physical, emotional, and spiritual well-being, that God, you would just touch them, minister to them. May their families be full of hope for the future, full of life and joy. And Father, it is my heart's desire that their lives may be marked by your divine favor, in Jesus' name. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you his peace. In Jesus' name, amen. At this time, we're going to sign the registry. So if I can ask my two witnesses, if they would mind coming, we'd appreciate that very much. Thank you. I'd like to introduce for the first times in our lives in just a second. There we go. Mr. Dave Postal and Mrs. Ann McCaffrey Postal. At this time, Dave and Ann would like to have something that they want to share from their hearts with their families and friends.
First of all, we're going to ask our sons to come and join us here at the front.
We just feel so blessed to have our family and friends meeting together, some here, some at home, online. We just want to say thank you so much for each one of you and the input that you've had into our lives, and we appreciate each one.
Right from the beginning, both Ann and I, we were so grateful for the way that our sons have stood with us, and just the way that they have extended their blessing to Ann and I. And part of the purpose of this moment right now, not only to give thanks to all of you for being with us today and online, is this is so deep in our heart right now that we would extend the blessing that is within our hearts to you, our families, our sons. And it just means so much to us that you can be on the receiving end. Just as you have stood with us, we are standing with you. And I want to just make a comment here that part of the blessing is connected to value. And we want you to know that whether you are with us here today in person, and we just have a handful of people, as well as those online, it doesn't matter whether you're here or online, we value each and every one of you. As sons, you represent our families. You represent your children, your spouses, and our grandchildren. And we value you incredibly. And our blessing is attached to that.
And I pray that our love can be an inspiration, that you will be blessed in everything that you put your hand to, that you'll love and be loved, that you'll know and be known. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone, for being with us today, here in person and online. And I'm so thankful for my bride. And you're beautiful, Anne. I love you. And I look forward, as we've already shared earlier, of spending the rest of my life with you. Thank you.
Upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord's